travel on. There's one day here and the next day gone. Sometimes you bend, sometimes you stand, sometimes you turn your back to the wind. There's a world outside every darkened door where blues won't haunt you anymore. Where the brave are free and lovers soar. Come ride with me to the distant shore. We won't hesitate to break down the garden gate. There's not much time left today.
Life metaphorically is a highway. 6 minutes after 10 o'clock, it's time to talk about the cars that we drive on the actual highway. Matt Gibbs is here. He's the owner of Sunrise Automotive. His program is called Auto Repair with Personal Care. Your calls are an important part of the show. Your car is important to you. And if a question being answered might help you be more happy with your car, then give Matt a call right now. The number is 622-WOCA, 622-9622. Good morning, Matt. How are you?
I'm good, Larry. How are you?
Pretty good. My car sounds a lot better.
It does.
Yeah. Can I tell my story now? Yes. I waited all week to tell this story. So last week, let's see, was it last? Well, my car had been making a noise for a while. And last week on the show, I told you about the noise. And I said, I'm going to bring it to you this afternoon. So last Monday afternoon, I went to your place and you drove my car. And I sat in the passenger seat, which you look so small in my... And I must look gigantic on the other side. But anyway, which I look gigantic anyway. But anyway, so... Then you go on Highway 27, also known as whatever. It's got 100 different names. And you are driving my car like it's never been driven before. You are going completely as far left as you can go from the bicycle lane on the right side to as far right as you can go back into the bicycle lane, swerving back and forth. Any policeman who saw you would have pulled you over in a heartbeat. And you would have said, it's not my car, it's his. And you did this so you could hear... the noise better, and you said to me, do you hear it? I said, well, not really. I don't really hear what you hear, but you heard something different. And not only did you hear something I couldn't hear, but you actually diagnosed it from that. You not only diagnosed what it was, but where it was. I was totally blown away, not to mention, in fact, scared. But I was scared of the driving. But aside from that, just even if I wasn't sitting in the car, the fact that you can just with your own ears, A, tell what it is, and B, tell where it is, I was amazed. And was left, what was wrong with it?
Left rear hub bearing assembly.
The left rear hub bearing assembly. All right. Yep. And you can actually tell from the swerving back and forth. Wow. So do they all sound the same?
No, that's why I have to swerve. If they all sounded the same, then I wouldn't have to swerve.
Oh, really?
But it just gives me the information that I need.
And swerving does what?
In the wheel bearing on that, a lot of the new cars, they don't have, you know, back in the day, we used to take wheels off and clean the bearings and repack the bearings and put them back in the car. Well, right. they don't, there's still a few cars out there that use that system. Most of them don't use it anymore. Most of them have gone to a sealed bearing unit. You know, it's the lug nut system.
Is that what mine has?
Yeah, yeah. It's a whole hub assembly, and there's two bearings in that in each one of the four hubs. So depending, you know, by swerving the car back and forth, I can change the load on I can go to a particular bearing.
Okay. So now, what would have happened had I not had it fixed?
I mean, the wheel could have fallen off.
The wheel could have fallen off.
Because it's...
Yeah. That's horrible. Not only could I have endangered myself, I could have killed somebody else. Yeah. I don't know. I couldn't live with that if I did that.
But trust me, when we were going on our little escapade,
right,
you know, it would be so bad that even you would be able to hear it. You know what I'm saying? Well, I mean, it would be so bad.
I could hear it. I just couldn't... Well... This is what you said to me. You said it was a small noise. This is a big noise. So that was, you mean it could be even bigger?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Okay. But still, had I not addressed it, had I just let it get worse and worse and worse, eventually the wheel would have come off.
The wheel would have come off because that assembly is what holds the wheel to the car.
Gosh.
You know, that's when we replace that hub bearing, you know, you take your lug nuts off and take the wheel off.
Right.
Well, the studs that the lug nuts go on,
right,
that's part of that assembly.
Wow. So when you see a car on the road that has had the wheel come off, is that what happened? Didn't pay attention to that noise?
Could have been. I've only seen one hub bearing actually come apart to where they drove it to just where it's not going to drive no more. I've only seen it once. But I have seen a lot of ball joints that break. That happens quite often. And that's something, you know, today's cars, I don't know why the manufacturers have chose to do this, but this is what they've chose to do. It's not what I've chose to do. It's what they've chose to do. But a lot of the front end parts, like ball joints, tire rods, idle arm, pitman arms, they're non-greasable anymore. They just they have a life.
And I was going to ask about that,
You know, and now the ones that we replace, when we replace ball joints and tie rods and idle arms and stuff, the aftermarket people, they put grease fittings in them. So now if you keep them greased, theoretically, they're almost last forever.
So if my left one went, does that mean my right one probably will go soon?
Well, I always look at that. If the left one went and the right one has the same amount of miles and pressures and times, you know, more than likely sooner or later, you're going to have to deal with the right one.
Have to hear that one too. It's like getting too...
Right, so when you hear a little noise, Larry, you call me.
Oh, man, I hope it doesn't happen. I mean, would there be an explanation as to why one side would wear out first?
Well, I mean, it's, you know...
I turn left more often than I turn right?
Well, I don't think so. I think when they assemble the bearings and stuff and they put the grease in them and stuff like that, you know, it's kind of like a light bulb. You know, I use this a lot. Okay. You know, you go... When I built my house, I went to Lowe's and bought a case of light bulbs and put light bulbs in all my light fixtures. Why did this one only last for 6 months? Why does this one for 3 years?
Good. I hope my other one lasts for the 3 year part of that.
Yeah. You just don't know. And I guess in a lot of garages would probably have, you know, sold the job as, well, your left one's bad. Do you want us to do the right one now? You know, while we're doing the left one.
Right.
And my philosophy is the right one's not making noise now, so let's not mess with it.
Right.
You know, and when we did yours, we put it in, I drove it, I took care of the noise, and I didn't hear anything. I went out and drove it the way I drove it with you to see if I could hear something starting with one of the other bearings, because that one was so bad you couldn't hear, you know, any of the other ones.
And I don't know if you want to mention price, but when you told me the dollar amount, I said to Robin, any other garage would have been three times as much.
Well, I don't know if they would have been.
You don't think so?
I don't know.
Every time I go anywhere, it's $1,000.
Right.
Everything I have to get fixed.
And actually, the price I told you, I didn't have a chance to see you when you came and picked up the car, but it was actually cheaper than what I told you.
Well, that's the good doctor does that, right? You give the worst possible scenario.
Well, when I looked up the price after driving it, I didn't know if it was with or without anti-lock brakes. Yours, that particular one, was without anti-lock brakes, so the part was cheaper.
Okay,
and that's why it was cheaper for you.
But still, just my own opinion. I've worked with a lot of mechanics, and I'm usually walking away with $1,000 bill, at least on almost everything. Headlights, that was $1,000. No, I'm teasing about that. But anyway, all right. If you have a question for Matt about your car, the number to call is 622-9622, 622-WOCA. You know what? And wouldn't that be a horrible thing to actually have an accident that could have been prevented with some maintenance?
Yeah. Yeah, that would have been. That would mess me up.
Yeah.
And if it's going to happen to somebody, it might happen to someone like me, because in my own car, I don't have time to do my own car.
So you got to do that, though.
If I heard what I heard in your car,
you would have
one of my guys would have been fixing my car.
And you actually, I'm sure you remember this. My car had the alignment out of alignment, whatever you call it, the wheels out of alignment. And you guys made that back. It was like a new car when you did that.
Well, that was more because we replaced those tires you had.
Oh, really? I had bad tires.
Yeah, because you remember
I didn't remember all these things.
We did. We put four brand new tires on it, and right. then we did the alignment. And
okay.
The tires is what really made the difference.
And you see, and I thought that the tires were what was the problem this time. I thought, they looked okay to me, but what do I know?
No, that was definitely.
That was definitely the bearing thing.
Here's a perfect thing. If we were driving your car the way we drove it with you in there, mm-hmm. okay, and let's say I was going hard left, hard right,
right.
hard swerving back, across right. the highway, and the noise didn't change, then I would that would have led me right to a tire. See what I'm saying?
Oh, okay.
That would have brought me to a tire. That would have brought me to look and say, okay, what's going on with the tires here? It's not changing. So because the tires are flat on the road, they wouldn't necessarily change. But because I did hear the change, then I knew right where the problem was.
By the way, you notice my steering wheel cover is like worn through.
Your steering wheel is worn through. You need to put a cover on it or a new steering wheel.
Well, it is a cover, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a wrap. That's what they wrap the steering wheel with. Larry's... Folks,
it is so hot.
Larry's
the metal
is down to the metal. If anybody has anything in their heart,
no, it is so hot when I get in the car. That piece of metal right there, I have to steer from the bottom of it. What's the driver's ed lesson? 10 and 2.
10 and 2.
My 10 is really hot. I have to have 2 and like 8 or something like that. So how's everything in your world?
Good. Everything's going good.
How's the car dealership gone?
It's going really well.
And what do you call it? Crossroads?
Crossroad.
Crossroad.
No S.
Okay, no S.
It's doing well.
Why is that important, no S?
Because is that the name of it is Crossroad. Everybody says Crossroads. Even I get could say it sometimes.
Okay, well, I'm trying to think of the reason. Crossroad, because it's the Christian double name, right?
Yeah, you know...
It's the road to the cross.
It's the crossroad.
It's the crossroad.
Yeah. And I guess my thought behind it.
It's like sunrise. It's a clever name.
Exactly.
Yeah.
It's it is what it is.
All right, let's go to the phone. And by the way, bringing God into this, I do thank God for you. I thank God that I got home safely from Sarasota, too. I drove all the way to Sarasota with that noise. Wow. Good morning. You're on the air with Matt.
Yeah, good morning, guys.
Hey, you.
How you doing, all?
Good.
See, I got to get your take on, did you probably heard that Harley-Davidson's going to come out with an electric motorcycle? And I talked to my brother-in-law up in Wisconsin, Milwaukee area, and in fact, everybody I know up there has got motorcycles. It's, you just have to have a motorcycle up there. And he's just about died laughing on the floor when I brought the subject up, and he said, I don't know about you, but he says, I've got stock in Harley-Davidson, and I know I do, and he knows I did have stock in it, and I still do it. He said, you better dump your stock, because that's going to be a very, very bad move for Harley, because probably one of the biggest reasons is not only their reputation, but it's the sound of that motorcycle that gets people all riled up and buying them. So I don't know what do you think about that?
Well, when you mentioned that was the first thing that came to my mind is what's an electric Harley going to sound like?
Right, exactly.
So maybe you have like a hidden DVD player or CD player and some speakers just to give it its sound.
Yeah. Well, I've been of course I'm from the Milwaukee area. I'm born and raised up there, and I've had Harley stock for many years, and quite a bit of Harley stock. And like my broker said, just sit on it, don't even read the papers, and in time you'll do fine. But I don't know, I'm afraid that this is going to be a big lemon for them, and might be a big problem. I'm almost thinking about calling the broker up and seeing what he thinks about it, maybe getting out of there.
I don't know if I do that, and let me tell you why. Here's my thought on this whole thing. When it comes to alternative fuel, electric cars and the hydrogen and the biofuels and the algae fuels and all this stuff, and when Honda and Toyota came out with the hybrids and stuff like that, here's the deal. This is what I've seen, and this is just my own opinion, okay, is that there's a group of people that are very conservative about the planet. They care about the planet. And even though they can go buy this car, and this car may get 60 miles to the gallon, and it's a hybrid, and it has a battery backup system, and yada, 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 but it's $22,000 more. All right? They'll go and buy that car because it's safe to the environment. Not understanding that it's going to take, here's this car that's a hybrid, and here's the car that's non-hybrid.
Right.
And it's $12,000 less. They don't care. It's not about the money. It's right. about what it's supposed to do.
Right.
And you know, then you sit down and say, okay, do you realize that by the gas savings from this car to this car, it's going to take you 15 years to recoup the difference in money? I don't care. It's protecting the environment.
Right.
They don't care. The protecting the environment part is all they care about.
Right.
So here's an alternative. Here's another thing that someone can enjoy, even though it might not sound really good. It might not perform like a Harley performs because there's, well, I don't know, after what Don Gartlitz did, you know, after what we saw last week.
Right, right.
Never know how it's going to perform.
Right.
But does that open a door? Does that allow opportunity for a whole nother group of people to maybe get involved with something that they haven't been involved with?
Right, right.
But then on the flip side, you got Harley guys and you get muscle guys and you have classic car guys and you they don't necessarily, it's not that they don't care about the environment, but they're not going to go and change their lifestyle for the environment kind of thing.
Right.
Right. You know? Does the disposal of the batteries in these cars, does that potentially going to be a problem? If we have so many batteries for these battery cars, is our landfills going to be very toxic because of that? Like, is that something, is that the campaign of the future environmentalists? Are they going to say, let's go back to gasoline or something?
Well, let's look at, I mean, I have in my shop, the government is, I have to pay, I mean, if I put a battery in your car, just in your car,
right?
Okay, that battery is, I mean, it's scrutinized all the way from the time it leaves my shop, your old battery.
Right, right.
It's not put in a landfill. They're recycled. There's lead in them. There's, you know.
Oh, okay. So they are very, the battery people are responsible and all that.
Now, the batteries that they're using in these electric cars and stuff like that, they're not the conventional type battery that, you know, that we use in our internally combusted engine. I don't know what they really compose of. I don't know what they're made of, but I'm sure that there's elements inside that battery that once the battery's gone, it's processed through a certain process.
Well, and you know, pollution was the reason for having cars. The sales pitch, do you remember this? Cars were not as dependable as horses, but horses pooped. And they were making the streets really dirty. Yeah. If you get a car, it'll be so much cleaner around here.
Yeah, right.
Do you remember? I mean, we don't remember that, neither one of us, but that's what the history teaches us, right?
Right.
So we've always been trying to convince the public that you should do the next thing because what we're doing now is too dirty.
Right. That's a good point. That's a good point.
And I guess it would be true. I mean, can you imagine if just replace every car on State Route 200 with a horse? Can you imagine how poopy that would be?
That stank. That stank.
What would you do for a living? You'd have to be putting horseshoes on things.
Yeah, I'd be fixing wagons.
Matt, I got a sound in my horse. Well, get on the back. Let's see what it is. Okay. Oh, Matt, you're driving my horse so bad. This is crazy. I got to see which hoof has to have a shoe changed. Good morning. You're on the air with Matt.
Hey, good morning, Matt and Larry. Harley-Davidson has recorded some of their larger engines, and it's going to be an option on the new electric motorcycle. It'll have a nice Bose
really?
Weatherproof speaker system built into it, so you don't lose that excitement of hearing a large V-twin motor down the road. Now, whether it has a built-in device to create the shake, vibration, and rattle, I don't know. Yeah, who could only guess?
Wow.
See, they even thought about it.
Yeah. Well, a modern camera. You click it, it
don't
doesn't...
believe me.
Oh, you're making it up? Oh. We figured you would know.
Yeah, we thought maybe you got on the internet and plugged right on in to HarleyDavidson.com.
But Matt, there is a car that I've been following for over a year and a half now. It's called an Elio, E-L-I-O. Have you followed that at all?
No, I haven't.
It's going to be built in Shreveport, Louisiana, in an abandoned GM assembly plant. Under $7,000, 84 miles to the gallon, air conditioning, and automatic transmission.
And it's all electric?
No, gas. Yeah. Not a hybrid. Just gas.
Just gas.
E-L-I-O. I'll talk to you guys later. Have a good day. Always good to hear you.
Thank you. I thought he knew. Well, I was going to say, you know, the modern cameras have the sound of an analog camera, the digital cameras, they click, click, whatever. That you can turn that off. That doesn't need to be there.
Right.
So they made that sound part of the camera experience. Good morning. You're on the air with Matt.
Good morning, Larry, Matt.
Morning.
Yeah, that Harley electric motorcycle, it's also going to have an oil tank you have to refill about every 2 weeks, and it has a simulated oil leak. So it'll be like the little Harley.
Oh, no.
You can get the genuine experience of putting a drip pan under your bike every night.
No. All right. I know where this show is going today.
Wait a minute. Let me see if I can get the sound on here. I think I found the sound. I'm playing a video. There it is. That's the way it's going to sound.
Yeah.
So you got to do it yourself. It's a do-it-yourself sound.
Okay.
Here's the electric Harley right here. Well, now you know. See? You learn something new every day.
Every day.
Matt, what's that sound? I don't know. Let me swerve all over the road. I'll figure out where it's coming from.
George has got a cold.
I think it's that guy over there. I think it's that guy. Listen to him. He's got big cheeks. Where's the sound? Ah. There it goes. This is a whole chorus of guys there. Yeah, the bike week would be so different, wouldn't it?
Yeah, it would, wouldn't it?
Can you actually go to Daytona and you hear that all over the place?
Or not hear nothing?
All right, let me do something over here. So, well, thank you for fixing my car. I hope you get thanked by the customers all the time.
We do.
Because it really is such a good feeling. It is an amazing feeling. It's like being cured of a disease. It is. When you come out of the shop, the car had been making a ton of noise, and now it's not making it anymore. It just feels so good. Like, did I ever tell you about the plate I have that I want to return to the church that baptized me?
Huh.
All right, real quick story. It's in New York. It's in the Bronx. And after my mom passed away, I got that plate off of her wall, and I said, you know, I want to return it to the church. It was a fundraiser for the church back in 1955 when I was born. So I thought, wouldn't it be nice to bring that? They probably don't have one. So I want to actually drive it to them, go to one of their services and say, by the way, I got a plate that's as old as me, that's 60 years old. I want to bring it and give it back to you. But I want to do it in my car. I don't want to fly, you know? So if my car is making that noise, then I couldn't, I wouldn't feel comfortable driving. So when you fixed it, then I thought, wow, now I can go back.
I can go back and give back to church their plate.
Yeah.
They gave you in 1955.
Right, right.
Wow, I feel accomplished today.
Matt, what's your phone number?
My phone number is 690-1993.
See, Matt, get your car fixed. If you have an electric Harley, he can add a sound to it.
Yeah.
Now that we know how to do it. Thank you, Matt.
Thank you, sir.
All right, we'll be right back. There's one day here and the next day gone. Sometimes you bend, sometimes you stand. Sometimes you turn your back to the wind. There's a world outside every darkened door where blues won't haunt you anymore. Where the brave are free and lovers soar.
Fox News Radio, I'm Pat O'Neill. Secretary of State John Kerry meeting with Iraqi Prime Minister Maliki. One goal, to persuade the government to give a